back with more tips, tricks, and bug workarounds for Star Citizen. This video will cover version 3.8. This patch brings us new truck stops all across Stanton's system. Each truck stop is complete with a habitation which you can use to spawn at. Some of the servers are experiencing a bug where the elevator will not go up to the fifth floor of the habitation. If you experience this bug and are trapped in your hab, your only option is to switch servers. If you are on a server with a fleet of friends and do not want to change servers, you can log out from your ship's bed on a pad after escaping the habitation, and then rejoin your friends on their server. For more details about this, view my previous video on how to properly join friend sessions. The new mission, A Call to Arms, will give you bounties for every enemy you kill with a crime rating. Accept this mission when you log on to receive extra revenue.
Congratulations.
Navigating in Star Citizen 3.8 is a brand new challenge. Trying to land at an outpost on a planet, setting your destination to said outpost will leave you navigationally blind while making your final approach. To avoid this, set your destination to the planet itself and simply spool your quantum drive without opening MobiGlass to warp to the outpost. After warping to the location on the planet without setting a destination to it, you can now open your MobiGlass and set a destination to get a marker and distance. This does require spooling up your quantum drive and turning it back off to get the actual distance. When trying to warp to an object whose direct line of sight is obscured by the planet you are near, your navigation system will try to set a route directly without using orbital markers as waypoints. To get around this, first set a destination to the planet which you are on, and spool up your quantum drive as you begin your ascent. You should see an orbital marker overhead to warp to. After warping to your orbital marker, you may still not see your destination and line of sight. If so, simply warp to any other object in space in line of sight, and simply shut your engines off with the I key after clearing the planet. You should now be able to warp to your intended destination. When approaching a planet's surface with cargo, never use cruise control while your ship's orientation is below the horizon line. If you pitch down with cruise control on and your game crashes, your ship will continue flying into the planet until it explodes. If you do not use cruise control, your ship will immediately come to a stop where you disconnected. Landing at Lorville has new challenges this patch as well. While your ship will no longer explode if you enter a no-fly zone, autopilot will take over and attempt to move your ship away to a free-fly area. This feature does not function properly all the time and may crash your ship into the planet. To avoid this, fly over the spaceport while maintaining as high of an altitude as possible until you're directly over the spaceport. Angle down 90 degrees and fly straight down towards your hangar. to safely land in first person, follow these instructions. Point the nose of your ship to the front of the landing pad and slowly decrease your maximum throttle. Once your ship is almost touching the front of the hangar bay, slowly strafe down while pitching up until your pitch reaches zero, and then strafe straight down until your ship has touched down on the pad. If you leave a ship on a pad after landing and wait for the ship to be stored, you will receive a fine from the UEE for a parking violation. To avoid this, either pull another ship after you land or request takeoff immediately after selling. This works from the CBD or on the train and will open the hangar bay doors to prepare you for takeoff when you return to your hangar. If you want to use emotes while in street clothes, simply bind the emotes to keyboard keys via advanced customization controls. FPS weapons and mining tools will sometimes not fire at all. The best workaround for this bug is to bind the inspect item key to a keyboard key and inspect your weapon prior to shooting. Doing so will ensure your weapon shoots until you reload or reholster for another weapon. Flame jumper missions will sometimes not spawn any enemies. You can tell if these missions are bugged if there exists more than one marker for the mission location on your Moby Glass map. If you see more than one, you will need to abandon the mission and try a different one. Before abandoning any missions, be sure to untrack them first, as their markers will not disappear from the Moby Glass map if removed while tracked. While in warp, if you are interdicted by pirates, always be sure to immediately change heading and increase speed to maximum while attempting to avoid them. Pirates will both attempt to ram your ship, and there is usually a shipwreck directly in your path as you exit warp. Hitting these wrecks could cause a lot of problems. Truck stops now have warp points for the various mining claims that exist in them. Again, do not try to set destination to these locations, but simply spool your quantum drive and align to warp to them. When completing any claim jumper or NPC bounty missions, destroy the bounty targets and the claim jumpers before shooting any other enemy NPC ships. If you destroy them before you destroy your objectives, you will not receive any bonuses from the Call to Arms mission. Last, I'd like to help you navigate around Everest Harbor. Here you can see me taking off from Landing Pad 1. Off my port bow is Landing Pad 2. Landing Pads 3 and 4 are located on the other strut facing the planet Hurston. Recon is sitting on pad 4, and is right next to pad 3. We will now have Recon visit all 4 hangars at this station so that we can see where they are located physically. As Recon's elevator takes off, we can see that he is sent to the far side of the space station. This is Hangar 1. The hangar next to it is not in use, and as he heads to Hangar 2, we can see his marker move again. Now he will move to Hangar 3, which is on the other side of the space station between pads 2 and 3 near the neon signs. Again, the hangar directly next to him is unused, and Hangar 4 is at the end of the station near the strut holding landing pads 3 and 4. If you are trying to accept a player beacon from a friend to transfer money, you may find that you cannot see any broadcast beacons. If this happens, you have a phantom crime stat and will need to increase it further to expose the level 1 crime stat you already have and then clear your bounty altogether. If you do this, you will be able to see player beacons again. That's all the tips I'll be sharing this time. I don't care if you didn't like my video, and please don't subscribe to this dribble.